Anna Deloach and her husband, photographer and author Ned Deloach, had been studying blennies in the waters off Bimini. Blennies. Photogenic, cute, but dangerous? One summer afternoon in 1998, they learned just how dangerous a blenny could be.
Pike blennies are a small fish thinner than a soda straw that live in abandoned worm tubes. The males compete for the best locations near the females, displaying and making these amazing jumps, flaring their dorsal fins to attract the females.
A male, spotting the fin display of another, defends his turf aggressively. Battles can last for hours.
We'd been diving this particular patch reef for about 3 weeks. So we decided to get really close and get some of those close-up shots of them jumping, you know, kind of like the shots on Air Blenny.
Anna learned that day that there is a darker side to these comical-looking fish.
We dropped down and found our fish. They're really easy to spot when they're displaying. And we got really close so Ned could get the shot. I don't know what I was thinking. I put my finger out, right in front of the fish, and started imitating its display.
And before she could react, the blenny, blinded by instinct, struck.
It happened so fast, the blenny latched onto my finger. There was blood everywhere.
And then it was over, as suddenly as it began. Ned captured this dramatic shot at the exact moment that the blenny clamped onto Anna's finger. Blenny attacks are rare. Experts agree, Anna's attack was a direct result of her provocation of the blenny.
Each year, there's less than 100 blenny attacks worldwide. You're far more likely to die from shark attack than blenny attack.
I don't blame the blenny. I brought it on myself. I'll dive again, but I've learned my lesson. I'll keep my finger to myself.
Next time, on Day of the Blenny, Anna returns to the water to face her fears